Hi guys, come with me on a magical mystery adventure from Kacyiru Golf Course Road to the Mundi Centre on Rwandex Road. I'm heading over there to buy some cat food. As you can see, it's been raining recently. On the roads today. Turning left onto Embassy Row. If you turn right, the road ends at the American Embassy. If you turn left, it goes down to Kigali Heights Shopping Centre. Lots of countries have their embassies along this road, and it's really interesting to drive down it and look at the different architectural styles. Sorry, just checking the camera is securely attached. British Embassy on the right with the blue bollards. And I'm just going to pop over the road and get some petrol. Always fun trying to remember which side the key goes in. Filling up my tank costs about 4,700 francs, so around £2.90 or $3.70. Right, off we go.
We'll be right back.
just stopping to ask these policemen if it's okay to turn left. I always thought that it was, but there's an arrow that seems to say keep right. A few roads have become one way recently, so I just wanted to be certain, as there wasn't anyone in front to follow. Special sort of crazy that is Rwandan roundabouts. Nobody gives way to oncoming traffic entering the roundabout or on the roundabout. It's a total free-for-all. Makes life very exciting. Kigali Convention Centre on the right. It's pretty when it's all lit up. Notice the stop sign miles back from the junction, and there's no give way markings on the road at all. That's the UN building on the left. The blue gates are always a dead giveaway. That and the giant sign saying UN Economic Commission for Africa. Next to that is Rwanda Biomedical Centre, who made sure that we all got vaccinated during COVID. Eyes forward.
Oh,
that pedestrian crossing could do with a lick of paint. Speed camera on the right, those grey and black towers. There's no warning signs for them in Rwanda. Pedestrian crossing is so dangerous because it's hidden down a blind dip. You don't see it until you're on top of it, and there are no signposts telling you it's coming up. Right after it, you've got a crazy junction where you have to go out into oncoming traffic to see if it's safe to turn left, and there's no give way markings on anything. It's not so bad on quiet days like today, but in heavy traffic, it's a bit of a death trap. I've been gone for too long in a faraway land, trying to find my way in. Searching for where I did belong. Coming up with a plan, somewhere I can begin. Memories of my hometown keep crawling back in my head. Been around the world all this time, still couldn't match how we feel. We're just coming up to Rwandex Road. That looks like a beer delivery up ahead in the red crates. I can't wait to get home. Nothing else can compare on my way. I be there. Sunshine like a heavenly oasis. I can feel the love from the family of faces. The sound of my homeland. A good time, but memories of my hometown keep crawling back in my head. Been around the world all this time, still couldn't match how we felt. How we felt, I can't wait to get home. Now, this bit is fun. The Mundi Centre is over there on the left, so we need to do a U-ey across three lanes of traffic to get there. It's quiet on the junction today. Carry the roots in my soul. Feel the heat of the sun. This is where I was born. Music in the air of the night. By the sound of the drums, where the rhythm begun. Memories of my hometown keep crawling back in my head. And here we are, Mundi Centre. This is also where you'll find Amy's Candy, the best sweet shop in town, and Kweza Women's Brewery, Rwanda's first craft brewery.
I can't wait to get home.